is rated TV-MAL. It contains strong language and is intended only for mature audiences.
Thank you. revolution everywhere.
It is. You need like four paper straws, which requires how many more trees to die so you can.
Thanks, Retta.
Everyone's got lots of plastic straws. It's actually more environmentally friendly than plastic straws than fucking metal ones.
Well, they have those bamboo straws now, too. Those that are like the vitamins.
Oh, you can make them a torture device when you're done.
I don't need it to cool. I just drink it. It's fine. I'll get the lid off.
Yeah, Melanie Mack tweeted last yesterday that upon further review, Spider-Man 3 is you know, or something. And I'm
underrated.
I'm all compared to now. I agree with you. I totally agree. I mean, it ain't great, but like Ghost Rider, go look at both Ghost Rider films. They're better than any of the shit that's come out from Stage 4. All this stuff that we thought was just regular bad, and it is, but regular bad has now become okay because things have gotten abysmally bad.
Yeah.
It's all the intersectional feminism and all that shit.
Yeah.
Like, it made it so much worse because back then we didn't have those things. It was just, you know, objectively.
We know why it's bad.
But yeah, I mean, I was on
yeah.
We can guess why something is going to be bad now. A Marvel movie comes out and has a male character and a female character. We know what their arcs are going to be before we see a second of footage. So, to address anybody who says we want something, I don't want anything to be bad. I want it all to be good. I want to enjoy it all like I did most everything back in the day. I even found enjoyment in regular bad films like X-Men 3. I would go see them and go, this kind of sucks. We debate it in a normal way. But what we have now is subverted entertainment deliberately because of intersectional feminism and agenda. And we know why, and it's easy to guess because there's about six stories they can tell. So we don't want anything to be bad, but we will point out exactly why we don't like it. And if that upsets some chills, I really don't give a fuck. That's the hell
I love Relic Hunter. I've always loved Relic Hunter.
I've never seen that.
But it's like adventuring and discovering treasure and stuff. It's like, you know, it's Tears for Arrows as Indiana Jones. It's just nice.
That was a lot of people's views different. I think in ER's video about TLJ, that Ryan might have destroyed Star Wars on purpose, like physically. And asked him to.
Hey! Alright!
It's Gary's stream now!
My stream now! Ha! Because I knew Jim Kaz didn't see it.
Yeah.
Oh, did you see it now? Gary.
No. Did I see it now?
No, like, have you seen it? Because I heard it's like there's early releases for...
Oh, yo, Rings of Power? No, you know what? I just wanted to let people run with it because I know some dipshit did an entire live stream on me watching it early. And I'm like, yeah, I'm watching it early tomorrow, but I was seeing a trailer. There was a trailer. I saw Bullet Train. And they put a fucking Rings of Power, and my wife just starts cracking up. I'm like, they're torturing me now. So I
did you like Bullet Train?
Yes, I did. I absolutely did. I would give it like 7.5 out of 10 if I gave grades, because I walked out of it. My both my kids liked it. My wife liked it. I liked it. It's a movie. It's not gonna recreate. It's not gonna recreate cinema or anything. But it's kind of a throwback to the mid-aughts action movie. In the line of Smoking Aces. And yeah, like little Tarantino-ish. Mm-hmm. Guy who directed Deadpool 2 and Atomic Blonde. And he did a very good job on this one. It was pretty funny. And the two Brits, Tangerine and Lemon, stole it. That was...
They stole the show.
Fucking good.
Tangerine and Lemon.
If it's streaming, definitely go watch it. If you want to see it in the theater, sure. You know. Yeah, I like it.
It was fun, Gary. It was a fun movie.
Fun. There's no stupid fucking agenda in it. And
exactly.
But he's not even the best thing in the movie. He's not even near the best thing in the movie. He's good, but there you go. It's a power trailer. I mean, I'm sure it was just a trailer, but I saw the resolution of it. It just looked like shit. Utter shit. So I wasn't kidding when I said it looks worse on the big screen. It did. It looked 1,000 times worse. Because it wasn't meant to be on the big screen. It wasn't filmed for the big screen. So when people go to see it in theaters, by the way, props to whoever at Warner Brothers thought about re-releasing the original Lord of the Rings. So yes, it was Fellowship, which I watched. Fucking came at the same time Rings of Power is coming out. Well, you know, it, I think there's multiple screens, but I think it's also like one's at 6, one's at 7. Chef's Kiss, well played, Warner Brothers. You get my applause for that. That was Warner Brothers.
Of course, different companies, duh.
Yes. So, good for them.
Yeah. I was kind of thinking, this is like, you know, them kind of pushing. Oh, no, of course, it's Warner Brothers. It's the other rights holder.
Warner Brothers. Really? Yeah, they that was a dick move. Beautiful. I love you.
Well, no wrong with that. What was the other one you wanted me to do?
Not a lot of Hispanic representation in Rings of Power. Not a lot of Asian representation in Rings of Power.
Sounds kind of racist.
Yeah,
but representation means black in Hollywood.
It does. They can only do one race at a time. You know, that's why Chris Gore mentioned the Fortnite skins. Like, that's what's going to be.
Gary, I want to... I'm sorry to come in here on this, but there is a lot of Mexican representation. Mowing the lawns and being in the house.
And selling tamales to Hamas.
And selling tamales in plastic wrap.
Harflex. How dare you?
I used to get the best tamales from the street. Old lady outside of the Safeway on Mission. And I was taking my life in my hands because, like, these are just made at her house and she could have put whatever. She was just the nicest old lady. They were the best tamales. We had her, like, yeah, she, like, knew my name and we came out. $5. Big old bag. Classic bag of tamales that I take home, so good.
Yeah, there's an old lady here that sells them, and she, like, walks around with this giant cooler that she, like, puts like it, and she just, like, walks around. She's, like, 77 years old, and she, like, walks around with a giant cooler and sells tamales. I love
them. I have a question about tamales.
Yeah.
What are tamales?
Really good food. So they're, like, a meat product in like a breaded product that are wrapped in like, I don't know what the fuck they're wrapped in. I've never asked. It's like corn husk?
Yeah, something. It's like corn. Yeah.
Well, not a husk. The thing that goes around.
Yeah.
It's a husk, right? I think it's a husk. Yeah. And it's fucking awesome. Little hot sauce on top. It's
salsa verde.
I'm sorry. To the Brits, you cannot boil it.
No.
I don't think so.
Fry it?
Fried.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fry it.
Unbreaded!
Oh. What is? I thought
it's kind of
breaded.
Well, it's cornbread, though.
It was my turn.
Cornbread.
I saw
cornbread!
I saw something saying in the chat. So I just
Maybe your tamale chat was unbreaded.
Mexican food in the UK at all?
We have like shitty Mexican places. There's a place which is open up. It's like fast food Mexican, and it doesn't do. It does tacos and burritos, and Gary's like really talked these up. So I ended up getting a burrito. I had one bite out of it, and it was in a bit.
Oh my God.
It was repulsive. Now then. I'm not saying that burritos are repulsive, I'm saying the place that made them was, it's just, you know, get it out, it was awful. It had no taste, it was just like eating texture.
Burritos are technically Tex-Mex, they're not.
That's what it's called, the place is called Tex-Mex, like a Tex-Mex Express or something.
You have a Taco Bell?